Yeah, it's going to show some more music on old format again. Quite a lot of it, actually. To be honest, I wasn't sure if I actually wanted to bother doing this anymore, but why not? Might as well. Anyway, so some of what I'm going to show, what I'm going to do first, is what I got not all that long ago. And the rest of it is what I got today, which overall, my margin for what's worked or not has been really good. In fact, of what I got today on the tape, only one is fried, so hey, that's pretty good. Anyway, let's get this going here, and I'm going to start off with the same kind of category of stuff, and, well, I'll explain why I got as much as I did and why I didn't at all. Alright, so, my favorite instrument is the piano, pretty much. I like the organ, too, so, explains Bach. Anyway, so, I like the piano a lot, it's very nice and all that, but I don't really have anything that's just the piano music and nothing kind of other things, just focus on that, even if it's just classical music. So, well, when I went to the one usual place I go to for 50-cent tapes, I noticed there's quite a lot of them, and some like this I've noticed more than once, and I finally got it. So, you know, well, I couldn't help myself, I got quite a few of the ones that interest me, and there's one I got more things to say about than this. Anyway, like I said, I've seen this one around before in more than one place, but I didn't go for it. It's not exactly totally only piano, it's kind of 70-fied, it's disco-ified in a way. There's other stuff going on, but eh, I like it still. It's pretty good. This is actually part two of a second part, or maybe there's even a third, I don't know, but it wasn't completely obvious from just looking at it until you look at the back here, tape two, or the actual tape itself, which there's a lot of songs on here. Should be able to read that, it's clear enough. And Liberace did some of these, as you can see. I like it, but I like the other ones I have even more. Still, it's nice to have. So there's the one piano one. Let's go on about this one next. This is the most interesting one. It's pretty old. Might be the oldest tape I have. And while my nose doesn't work, I asked someone what it smelled like, the case. And apparently it smells like musty. But the tape itself is fine. Anyway, Beethoven. I like Beethoven quite a lot. I prefer Bach most. But anyway, not many songs in here, but they're very long. In fact, the two of these are on the one side, and the one's just the one, as you can see from the back here. But anyway... Moonlight Sonata is one of my favorite songs ever, so hey, it's cool that this is on here. This is an interesting tape for quite a few reasons. Just the one, the way it looks and its case is a little bit different than most others as the camera decides not to focus again. You can see Polygram put it out. I have records with their name on it. But the tape itself looks quite different to any I've ever had, which is interesting. And more than that, I admit, I still forgot to use the internet and try and find out when this came out. It's got to be from the 70s. Late 70s, but anyway, the only date that's on here, or even in the insert, is when the recordings were made, is 1965. But I also kind of find it interesting that this is one of the few things I have, if anything, that says West Germany on it. Where is it? There it is. Made in West Germany, so that definitely dates it. It's definitely before 1989. But anyway, that was a cool one. I had to go for that. Now, there's one after this individual tape, there's one more thing I want to show, which is actually a cassette. But just to mention this and get it out of the way, because I might go on about it too long, this is easily my favorite of the ones I got in this group I'm going to be showing. As far as the piano stuff goes, this one, it's got some great stuff on it. Really like it a lot. Also high quality tape too, which is nice. Of course you'd want that for this type of stuff, as you can see there. Anyway, it's actually easier if I show you the insert on this one, what's on it. If it focuses the way it should, there you go. Now if I hold it slow enough, you should be able to read these. Yeah, that's pretty good. And the thing itself, which is nothing amazing to look at. I like it a lot, it's definitely my favorite, like I said. Alright, now here's this next one, which I really like, because they're all in good shape. Well, there's one I want to say something about. And it's complete. This is something I don't know, I don't know the release, but I was testing them out and I listened to them. I like it a lot, it's pretty good, I've listened to them all now. It's from a company called Laserlight Piano Classics, and they have kind of odd covers. In fact, this is one of them. There's five. I'm not going to go over every single one, but I do want to talk about number two, which is kind of weird in my experience of this stuff, going back to it or even back originally. This is number five. That's four, the one that's on the cover. I know that's one. They're all out of order. Where's the one I need to talk about? Two. Okay, this is the one. Oddly, it's got an issue, but it actually plays perfectly normal, and it shouldn't. I don't know how or why. I don't know the name of the part, I forgot. The little soft thing there is called a pressure pad. It's basically all it's needed. Yeah, you can play the tape without it, but it sounds very metallic, and it's not good for the tape or the player, really. But it's so it actually sounds correct. Now, it's not in the right place it should be. This is kind of loose, the thing that it's attached on, but it's still glued on. I don't know what happened to it. I don't think you'll be able to see it. Maybe you can, like the one hook arm is pulled in there as I bump the camera. But this one isn't. Either that part's snapped off or whatever, but it actually sounds perfectly fine even though it's not where it should be. So, I don't know. Sometimes it moves a little more loose, so I just kind of like put it back where it belongs, but it works, so I can't complain. I don't know if I'll be able to replace it anyway, so there's that. I just wanted to make mention of it. Put it back in here before there's a mess. I really like it, though. Even with that one, it's a problem. The other ones are perfectly fine. I don't know how or why that happened, or much less why it can work, even though it shouldn't, correctly. So that's the piano stuff out of the way. Now let's get on to probably what's more interesting to most. Been, as I've said before, I mainly want soundtracks, but I've been kind of having a hard time finding those. In fact, I only found one today, as I'll show. And I think I only have one here in this group to show. But anyway, I probably shouldn't have gone for it, because I don't really want ones without the insert. You know, it's not complete in box. It's also a little kind of dirty in some ways, the tape itself, but it plays all right. It's a little wobbly, I'll be honest, but it's okay. I don't mind it. Yeah, another Disney one. Someone brought in a ton of Disney stuff there, and I couldn't resist getting this one. I actually kind of like the movie. I understand it's got a lot of problems and, you know, other things I won't get into, but I liked it, and particularly the music, so, you know, it was worth it to me to get this, so I can't complain much. I would like to replace it with something better, but for now, this is okay. It's not that bad. It's the tape itself, like the plastic housing, is kind of dirty, maybe you might be able to tell. I don't know, but it'd be nice to get one with the actual insert and is in better shape. Alright, speaking of wobbly, this one is throughout, but it's not that bad. Now, I actually have different greatest hits on CD. The very best is called Playlist. There's a whole range of that same one for various artists. Anyway, Barry Manilow, but there's some songs on here that aren't on that, and that's why I wanted it. But not a damn thing I see more than one tape at the same place. There's this Christmas ones, Barry Manilow, and a couple other ones. None of those have it. That CD one I have doesn't have it, and this one doesn't have this particular song, which I actually really like a lot from it. It's very disco-y. It's a very disco song. Who's Been Sleeping in My Bed, which Daft Punk sampled for Superheroes, or which song is it? I think it's Superheroes. They sampled it. It's just the one part that loops. But anyway, it's not on this one either. Wow, the camera really doesn't like that red. Anyway, it's not, like I said, it's a little wobbly, but personally to me, I don't really, it doesn't bother me. You don't notice it all that much if you just listen to it, you know, consistently, but there's some good ones on here, and like I said, some that are not on that one, so I don't mind it. It was 50 cents. Woo. Big spender. Alright, here we go. Another Sheena Easton one, and now I'm going to try and see if I can find the one that's in between, which I have a 45 of two songs from it. This is the one that came after the one I'm thinking of. I can't remember what it's called, and then I have Private Heaven, which I really like a lot. Some really good songs on this one, too, and this is when she was transitioning out of that kind of pop star type thing, but some of these songs still sound like that, so I don't know. The Lover in Me is probably my favorite on here, I'd say. It's a really good one. Can't complain at all without getting some more Sheena Easton, so that's good. I've been wanting to get some more rock. Not, like, later, but I like the older stuff, too, so I actually got some of that. And as ever, when I find this kind of stuff, I can never find all the parts, usually, except for, like, that piano thing. We're gonna see more of that when I get to the stuff from today. But anyway, some good stuff here. Happy Days of Rock and Roll's got some 60s, my bad. I'm trying to go from memory, and I'm already fucking up even though it says so. Yeah, this is not the first part of it. It's cassette 3, so I looked to see if the other ones were there, but they weren't. Maybe I'll see them some other time, but I can't complain with just having this one. It's got some good stuff on it, actually. I can see it better if I show it that way. This is what's on it. Try not to dwell on things as much as I usually do. Speaking of, now here's one I got some, I'll go with this one first. Once again, more evidence how I can't get all the parts or even just the first part usually for something. This one's quite far into the many parts. They've, as you can see there from the volume number, but some good stuff on this one too. I don't mind if I don't have all the parts or I'm just, it's out of order. Just some really good stuff on this. I mean, it starts off really strong with Hole in the Come by Sam and Dave. It's a great song. I love that one. But the tape itself is also one I don't really see much often. It's black and also has a yellow, I usually call it primer. That's not actually what it's called, but I can't remember exactly. Sorry. But it's a good one. I don't mind it being out of order. My bad. Now getting to what I like even more. I mean, I like 60s rock, don't get me wrong, but I really like 50s music. So I got two here for 50s music, and they really got my attention just for the covers alone. This one especially. Pretty sure it's supposed to be a Bell, 1957 Bel Air radio, but whatever. So quite a few 50s cars had a similar looking one. But this one was also interesting to me for another reason. It has Shell's logo on there, and I'll get into that in a second. But in the past, you could get CDs, cassettes from gas stations, but this one is just a little bit more than that. And it's also not the first part of a thing. It's part three, I think, isn't it? Hold on, let me look on my hand. Yeah, volume three, it's up in the corner. Again, so what? I like the songs that are on here, I can't complain at all. And just to go with side one. You can see what's on here. Starts off with Johnny B. Goode. And even some Beach Boys. Now let's get into the Shell thing. It's also used to promote, well, obviously this is way late to do this. The prices aren't even the same anymore. But still, it's pretty cool, I think, to have a Shell cassette. And if you didn't notice the Shell logo on the cassette here, that's pretty cool. So I consider it to be like an automotive collectible, quote-unquote, much like that Ford one I showed last time. So, hey, that's pretty cool, I think, as I keep bumping the camera. It is what it is. All right, next, more 50 stuff. And can't go wrong with a 50s car in there. That's a Cadillac. Anyway, much the same, just like the other one. This is not the first part. It's only volume two, so I'm not that far out of whack. Not much tape, as you can probably tell. It's also a high-quality metal CR-02 one, which is pretty cool. And if I hold this still enough, you should be able to read what the songs are on here. It's good ones. That's why I don't really care that I don't have the first part, but it would have been nice, you know, to have more. Really like 50s music, so I would just like to get more in general. What one to do next? All right, here's one. Here's a kind of specific tape I've actually been wanting to get, and today I found two others. Well, one I just wanted, it's not so much on tape or that kind of thing. The other one literally is a specific one I wanted, if not on tape. Anyway, I like Laura Branigan quite a lot, and this is the self-titled album, Branigan, which also has the missing song that's not on the Flashdance soundtrack, because it's a mystery not known to me why it's not, which is Gloria, which is a great song, and it's the second one on the first slide, so hey, I can't complain with that. Some energetic stuff, but there's also a few slow songs on here, much like that A Private Heaven from Sheena Easton. But yeah, I've always been a fan, so I can't really complain. You can see what the tape looks like here. Another Atlantic release. So I was happy to find this one finally. Okay, now this one's a little bit... When I was testing out, I was listening to songs because they're not ones I'm really familiar with from her, and I'm not that huge on her, but I liked what I was hearing, so I decided to go for it. 53 cents. Woo! Anyway, it's in good shape and all that. It's much later stuff that I'm used to with her. Tell It to My Heart is her most famous song. It's the one I know, too, but whatever. Taylor Dane. This is not an album I know really much well. It's called Soul Dancing. It's also one of those ones from the 90s at that one point where they had the thing that covers over so you can't actually see the back of the tape. I don't know. I'm half and half on that. It's okay. And, of course, the plastic's in the way of trying to read what the hell's on it. And if I go slow enough, you should be able to read. She actually does a cover of a Barry White song in here. Where is it? Can't Get Enough of Your Love, I think, is that one? Yeah, I think that's the one. But I actually don't mind her version. I'm so used to the Barry White version. I do prefer his, but hers isn't that bad. I actually like it a good deal. And here's what the tape itself looks like. I thought this one was dirty. Guess not. Anyway, so that was a kind of a nice surprise to find. Then I, you know, since they let me test it, and all people or places will, I got to liking it, so I thought, hey, why not? Even though I'm used to her older stuff, and I prefer it. Okay, so here's the last thing to show from this place I went to, and this is really the biggest surprise, yet not my favorite tape of the ones I got there. I didn't expect to see this at all. Now, if you're into disco at all, you know it's very big in Italy. I mean, Giorgio Moroder, I think for once I actually said his name right, who's commonly considered the godfather of disco. He's Italian and had a lot of influence with that kind of stuff, but even then there's a ton of Italian disco out there. I see some of it now and then on record. I don't really go for it because it's nothing I specifically know of, but this was so cheap and it's in great shape and just kind of a cool oddity. I'd go for it. Much like that Beethoven tape, though, it's a mystery, at least to me, when the hell this came out, because apparently they couldn't be bothered to put out the date. It's also, I think, of any music I have on CD, record, or tape, only three mediums in tangible form I bother with for this stuff, that has the weirdest cover. Well, to me it is. I'm not good at Italian unless it's some things related to automobiles, so I'm not even going to try and pronounce things right, so there you go. Fantasio Vanzi, and I don't know. I know some who can actually speak Italian really good, but anyway, it's a hat like the gondola people will have, and sunglasses on sort of on top of that tower. And now I might be wrong. Don't say it is set in stone or quote me on this, but I think this is Venice. Might be. I don't know. If the words weren't there, I might be able to tell better, and that wasn't so distracting. It's in really good shape, though. I never expected to see this, but it gets even better. Not only is this entirely Italian disco, and everything's in Italian. Everything is in Italian. This is the name of the album. Un Disco di Oro. That's actually one of the songs in it. And this is the group, I'm pretty sure. But anyway, you might be able to see the thing here, and that's what I want to talk about. It's an Italian import, which is pretty cool. The stamp's still here. Pretty sure that's what that means. It's kind of faded, but you can sort of see it. Wait a minute, I gotta figure out which way is up. Because of YouTube and compression and shit. And while this is a good camera, it's not like the best camera in the world. Alright, that's the best it's gonna get. I can barely make it out myself, even with my own eyes. But that's pretty cool when I saw that there. So I didn't expect to just see Italian disco just hanging out in there, especially on tape. I've only seen it on record. And apparently that's how you say side A in Italian. And well, if you know any Italian better than me, you can read this and understand what the hell's going on. But as I said, there's no freaking date on this, so I don't know when it came out. I can make a guess given it's disco and all, but I mean, I'm gonna look one more time to see if I can see anything. Nope, not a damn date anywhere on this. Who the hell knows when this came out? It's in stereo, I can tell you that. But if you're curious how long the songs are, there you go. I have listened to it in full, both sides, more than once, and I like it quite a lot, so hey, I can't complain. It was really a cool surprise, I think, definitely. Alright, now for what I got today, August 3rd. A really good turnout, especially considering I didn't expect to find any tapes, given where I was, and there pretty much never is. So I was surprised, and I actually got some stuff I really wanted, but sadly, of all of them, and this is a really good margin, and, well, it seemed like at first every single one was going to be perfect, but there's always got to be a dud. And I'm okay with this one not working out, but at the same time, it's a little disappointing at the same time. Whatever. Didn't lose much, 50 cents. Jay Giles Band, it's Freeze Frame. There's some good songs in here, but it's borked. I don't know. F it. The case will be saved in case I need an better one. Anyway, some of these actually I could probably replace them because they're sort of dirty. But the first thing I want to talk about is something I actually don't want to open yet. I like new retro wave or whatever. It's basically 80s music made now, dark synth wave, whatever the hell you want to call it. The easiest way I explain it to people is it's 80s music made now. I like quite a lot of it, like Laserhawk, Perturber, there's just a lot of them. Mega Drive is one of them. Trying to think who else. There's quite a lot of them. But this one here got my attention. I was listening to it and I really liked it a lot, so I was going to buy it. So, you know, get it digital, you can get it FLAC and all that. I've done that with quite a few others. But then some of them actually do offer them in physical form, like special CDs, records, or even cassette tapes, which interests me. And for a while now, I've kind of thought it'd be cool to get an official release from one of them on a tape. And I was waiting on this one, and then I noticed one day, well, there's only 9 left. So I had to jump on it, and well, it actually came in today, and I wasn't expecting it because even on the thing, it said they weren't going to ship out until August 19th, which is not August 19th yet, 2 days after my birthday. So I was considering this as like a very late birthday present to myself because I was expected to come in. Now it comes in early, so now it's an early birthday present to myself. So, you know, you still get a digital version of the album, which is cool, very nice of them. So I technically paid only a little bit more, and I got a physical release. Now, this is the kind of funny thing to me. Tapes aren't that expensive even now, and you can still get new blanks and all that, and there's companies that will still put stuff out on tape. I mean, given the resurgence that's happened and all that, I mean, I've shown it before. I have the Stranger Things on soundtrack. I have Guardians of the Galaxy 1 and 2 on tape, but that makes a little bit more sense. You know, it ties in with, you know, how Star-Lord, what he does and all that, and the Stranger Things 1 because it takes place in the 80s. But I also have a reissue. I think I'm pretty sure I showed it last time. I got a reissue of the Purple Rain soundtrack because it's a purple tape. Fitting, you know. But so you can get new ones, but they're not all that expensive to make. So it was a little funny to me when I saw how many of these are limited by, and this is now the most, when it comes to tangible official releases for any kind of music I have on those three formats, is the rarest one I have now. There was not many left, so I had to jump on it sooner than I wanted to, was my point. The funny thing is, the record release was limited to only 100. Tapes, which are much easier, cheaper to make, and so on and so forth, they were limited to 50. So I have one of 50 for this. And like I said, I don't want to open it yet until I want to listen to it. It's a new artist, actually. He's from Ukraine, I think, or whatever. I don't know. I was listening to the music, and I liked it a lot, as I said. This is his debut album, actually. The album is called Parallels, and the artist is Earmake. Really like the artwork. That's pretty cool. As I said, I don't want to take the tape out yet, but as you can see, the tape itself is purple, much like the purple ring one, which I thought it was blue when I was reading the thing. I must have got it wrong. Yeah, you can kind of see it when the light goes through it. It's purple. So, it's very minimalist, it seems. Actually, really interested to see what else, you know, is there to look at and read. Now, I could open it on camera here, but, you know, I don't want to open it just yet because, you know, well, things. But I'm definitely glad. I was a real surprise today, on top of all the other tapes I got, that this came in early. I wasn't expecting that at all. Because, well, again, like what I read on the thing, it said shipping out August 19th. Anyway, so that's the rarest music I have now in a physical form. Okay, we'll do with this one. Now, I actually got this before, but it was all fucked up. And what kind of chance or fortune did I have? I found it today for much less than that one. It was fucked up. And not only that, it's in perfect shape. I really wanted this one quite a lot. I like Fabulous Thunderbirds a good deal, especially the, you know, their most famous song, of course, Tough Enough. But the rest of these are really good on it, too. Amnesia I like a lot in particular. They actually, now, I like the Eurythmics a lot, but this one song isn't their most popular, and it's not the most common you'll find on any kind of album release, especially the Greatest Hits or anything. They did a song, Wrap It Up, but they did too. Now, this is 1986. I can't remember when the Eurythmics did theirs, but I think they did theirs first, so they're doing a cover of their version. I'm so used to the Eurythmics one, it's much like that Barry White thing I was talking about however many minutes ago with Taylor Dane. But I am so used to the Eurythmics version, I like it a lot, but in a way, I kind of think I like their version more of Wrap It Up, which, it's here somewhere. Yeah, there it is, Wrap It Up. Anyway, so I was really happy to come across this today, and it actually works on like that other one, so hey, can't complain with that at all. All but the G. Giles one, like I said, all work perfectly. Alright, what next? Okay, here we go. I'm not massive on Jim Croce, but he does some really good music, and this is, well, I like Greatest Hits, I think I've mentioned this before, so couldn't go wrong with this one, and, well, I like it a lot. Of course, it's got Don't Mess With Jim, which is also on the Stranger Things soundtrack. Also, and you got Bad Bad Leroy Brown. It's just really good music all on this here, so it wasn't much, and I had to go for it. I couldn't resist. So, there you go. It's not one of the more familiar record albums, release companies I know of, but hey, whatever. Just to point that out. So there's that one. Alright, here's something I was hoping to find specifically, not so much on tape or whatever. I think I saw on CD once and I should have got it, but I didn't. I never see it on record, I just see random stuff for her. Actually, quite a big fan. And so, it turns out, I got lucky and I got it on tape, and the case took all the punishment, and it's pretty dirty, which is, you know, good, and saved the tape, and it's perfect shape, and I'm really happy I got this. Of course, a much later release would have more songs, but other than Romeo not on here, I can't complain, which I have that on the Flashdance soundtrack on record. But anyway, Donna Summer Greatest Hits, well, at least that's what it says on the front here, but its actual title is The Summer Collection, and it starts off with my favorite song of hers, She Works Hard for the Money. But anyway, as you can see here, all good ones, and quite a few Gigiaro Moroder had something to do with, so hey, nothing much to complain about there. I finally got something I've been wanting, the Donna Summer Greatest Hits, so I cannot complain with that at all. I didn't care if it was on tape or whatever. At the time, I wasn't even going back to tapes yet. All right, here's another one I've been specifically wanting to get. I like Phil Collins quite a lot. I like Genesis a good deal. But this particular album, I never had at any point, but I like the songs on it, especially I Can't Dance, which is my favorite of theirs. I don't know, it's really catchy. I just like it a lot. But anyway, I finally came across this, so yeah, I can't complain at all. Some very long songs, but good songs. And well, the tape's nothing special to look at. But there you go. I'm happy I finally got this one. What next? Let's do this one. I like George Thorogood a good deal. Of course, Bad to the Bone is a really good song. I like that one a lot. I have that one 45. This album in particular is not one I know very well, or even the songs, to be honest with you, by memory or by title. Still, it's really good. I like it a lot, and I can't complain with it. So, you know, I like that I got it. And you can see the songs here. Alright, what next? I'll do those together. Alright, let's do more rock. Like I said, I've been wanting more later rock, and I finally found it. Another band, which it's more of a respect thing for them. I'm not huge on Rush, but I like them a decent deal, and this is another example of where I don't have the whole, like, release parts. But I actually have the first one. collector's limited edition contains three albums of music. Well, only two technically on this one. It's basically what I do with some blank tapes. I put one album I have on one side in full and then the other. So on this one, from Rush Archives, it's the self-titled album, Rush. And then on the other side is Fly By Night. So there you go, Jim. I finally found Rush on tape. If you see this, you'll know what I'm talking about. I like this. Can't complain with this at all. It's pretty cool that I came across it. If you're curious, oddly, it actually tells you what the songs are for Volume 2, even though I don't have it. I don't know why they would do that, not just put it on Volume 2, but you can see what the songs are on it, as well as how long they are, as well as how long this one is, which is much longer than that one. Okay, almost done here. All right, I said I haven't been able to come across many soundtracks lately, and it's true, but I actually have two here. One I already have, but I'll explain why I did that. Anyway, this is actual score music, which is what I really like getting, and not one I specifically have been trying to find or was hoping to find, but I can't complain with it. I like the first Conan movie the most, so it's fitting. Conan the Barbarian, yes, and not a composer I know specifically all as well. Not like a household name like John Williams or something, but this is very good stuff, very epic sounding orchestral, and usually it's harder to open than that, but for some reason it cooperated this time. And you can see what these songs are called here. It's always hard for me to, like, if I want to archive these and split up into parts, unless I know specifically what the songs sound like, I gotta look around for what they are individually so I can chop them up. There's one called The Orgy. Anyway. So, I got another soundtrack. Now, here's one I already have, but, again, I'll explain. I'm pretty sure I might have shown it in some video. More Prince, yes. The 1989 Tim Burton Batman soundtrack. Specifically, the music Prince did, not the score stuff, which I still want, also for Batman Returns. Anyway, I really like the music on this. I do have it on CD already, didn't spend much for that, but I did originally want it on tape, so for jackal much, I couldn't resist, and it's in perfect shape, so you know what, I'm fine with having it twice over. I like the movie so much anyway, so. I don't think I need to dwell on this one, do I? There's a, let's see, Michael Keaton Batman in there, which is good. Didn't expect to come across this today, though. Okay, almost done here. Alright, here's another thing. I wanted this for some time, but I never really spent much effort trying to find it on CD or anything, much less tape. And oddly, it was not that long ago I was saying to someone I kind of really would like Greatest Hits for him. Guess what I found today? Not that you can see it, because it's washed out because of the light. Buddy Holly Greatest Hits. Yes, 20 of them. Or Buddy Holly and the Crickets, to be specific. Anyway, I'm really happy with this. I can't complain at all, actually. So you can see what the songs are. Which side one? There it is. And and one of these was on the Christine soundtrack, the movie, not the score stuff, which I have the score, not the actual music, which that's expensive as shit on record. Never came out on CD. Hell knows why. You gotta part it out yourself and make your own, I guess. Anyway, only four more left. Let's do this one. It's another one where the case took all the punishment, which is good. Like Blondie, a good deal. I actually have quite a few 45s of her on there, but I like this even better. And it's got all the ones you could want on it, pretty much, for the most part. And, can't complain about that at all. Another one I wasn't really expecting to see here. I'm a big fan of Grace Hits, so, you know, one for her. I like that. This might be easier. No, it's actually harder to read. Usually the thing goes up higher. Anyway, so that was nice to come by. Alright, here's another one, which this requires a little bit of explanation, maybe. Technically, this tape here, I have access to. It's just one I borrowed from someone else. Exact same tape, came out the same year, yet oddly, theirs is black, where this one is white on the top and bottom. I don't know what that means. It's not, maybe it's a later release, but it's got the same copyright date, so I don't know. Anyway, I'm a big Foreigner fan, and you can't go wrong with these 10 awesome songs on here. By the way, the Double Vision is my favorite song of theirs. So, it's nice that I have my own for this, and it's in perfect shape, so you know what? I can't complain at all. Fantastic. Alright, last two, and more rock. And another one I'm actually a pretty big fan of, their this band. I actually have Icons on CD, but it's nice to have these at the same time on tape for not all jack-a-much. This one here I'll talk about first, and it's something I can explain, not that if anyone's interested. This is, and both of these are not the first parts for anything, so, or No, this one is. This one isn't. Okay, I want to make sure what I'm talking about. This is called Kiss Alive 2. I think you can tell what this is from the title. Yes, it's live recordings. Now, normally I despise live versions of anything because I don't like the screaming memes in the background. It ruins it for me. But listening to this, I gotta say, I'm actually okay with it. I don't mind it at all. And they sound just like they do in the studio versions, pretty much, with the music, which is also another thing I noticed that's not always all that similar. But anyway, this one, and you already know there's another Kiss one I'm going to show, which is studio stuff. But it's, you know, it's nice to have some Kiss stuff for a change on tape, which I never have before. So there you go, if you want to see easier what songs are in there. And like I said, this is part two, so that's why it's side three and four. But still some good ones on here. Icons is a greatest hits release, if you didn't know. I like that I have it. Each CD is basically like focused on each of the members. Anyway, of course, number one is Gene Simmons. So here we go with a normal release, not live. It's Rock and Roll Over. Yes. I like the cover. It's kind of cool to me. I don't know. And the songs on it are those, as you say. It's a little bit dirty. I might replace it with one of those other ones. When it comes to tapes, I don't really care if it's the original case or not. I just want a nice one that's not all dick. And so you can see the songs a little easier here. And there you go. That's all the tapes so far recently I got, including a new one and the most rarest physical release for any kind of music tape or otherwise I have. It's definitely the rarest tape I have. Second most would probably be Predator 2, as I said before. See what that goes for on eBay and you might understand what I mean. Still trying to find a better condition replacement for that, but I don't think I will. Anyway, so I don't think I missed any I should have shown that I got this time or that last other time, or I might have forgot before. Anyway, so, yeah, kind of took the same amount of time to do both showings. Anyway, so there you go. I hope maybe you found it interesting or enjoyed it or, I don't know, whatever. So that's it. I will see you later, and probably maybe it might be a game video related instead of music again. We'll see.